Hey guys, it is June 17th, 2014, and we are here at the closing of the Captain EO tribute. And as of this filming, it is not clear if this is the final closing of Captain EO or if it will reopen in maybe September or something like that. But it's basically going to be closing after tonight for a Guardians of the Galaxy kind of preview event, like they've done with a variety of other movies over the years, but usually they're across the way in DCA. And so this one, it's interesting, it's in Captain EO, and it kind of fits with the whole Marvel theme, what's going on in Interventions and things like that. And there's been a lot of concern just about Captain EO in general, because it does not draw a huge crowd very often. And you can kind of see right here, as I've been kind of circling back and forth the park, kind of waiting until we get to the final hours of it, a few times I just thought maybe it closed early already, but in the last 5 or so minutes I've been staying here, there's literally not been a single person that's gotten in the queue to be here. And this is kind of on a somewhat maybe historic night, so you get the idea of just it's not really drawing crowds anymore. And so it was cool when it came back, and it's kind of a tribute with Michael Jackson's death and things like that. And it's such a kind of cool retro 80s, you know, throwback. But the merchandise disappeared from Star Trader a few months back, and then actually the Captain EO name came off of the map and it started saying Magic Eye Theater again. And ironically, now as it's closing, it does say Captain EO in the program again, but basically it's really, you know, just kind of been on life support. And so there's a lot of people that feel that this may be the end of it. Now, usually Disney seems to kind of give everything a going, or not everything, but gives a lot of things a going away party. So I would be a little surprised if it doesn't reopen. But that being said, we like to be at, if possible, as many of the openings and as many of the closings of all these things. So we wanted to be here to kind of document this, if this is the end of Captain EO, to kind of go on it for that last time this night as it's closing right now. So let's go take a look inside. We won't be able to film the actual show because they do not allow filming of that, but I'll try and get us some of the queuing area and things like that, and just kind of a quick little saying goodbye to the Captain EO tribute. All right, let's go take a look around. There's about 2 minutes or maybe a minute now until the doors open for one of the last trips with Captain EO, and you can see the relatively small crowd here. And you know, again, this is the last night. I don't know how many people are here as part of like it's a going away thing, but that being said, regardless, just not much, you know. And you can't imagine it being more on other nights. The park's really crowded, you know. There's 45 minutes at things like Storybook, and an hour at Peter Pan, and an hour at Matterhorn and stuff, and it's just not attracting the crowd anymore. So as much as it's a cool thing for nostalgia, like so many of those kind of older things, they just don't attract the audience anymore. So, all right, looks like it's about time to head on in for a last trip with Captain EO.
Almost 25 years ago, the power of music, dance, and imagination came together to create an amazing out-of-this-world adventure. Now, Captain EO is back to change the world again. And here to begin our adventure is the original film Prelude, exactly as it appeared back in 1986.
Remember the 80s!
A few years ago, the Walt Disney Company and Kodak invented a totally new way to make 3D movies. An extraordinary camera was custom built and used only once. To create a magical 3D fantasy shown exclusively at Walt Disney World in Florida and here at Disneyland. The show was so popular that Disney and Kodak decided to use the camera again for an even more spectacular show. They brought together for the first time ever Star Wars producer George Lucas, director Francis Coppola, and superstar Michael Jackson, who along with Disney Imagineers created this new 3D fantasy. Get ready to blast off, for the magical adventure is moments away. But first, we'd like to share a backstage glimpse of some of the talented people who created Captain EO.
Your step as you enter. And for your safety, do not put on the 3D glasses until you are seated. If you need to leave the theater at any time, please exit through the doors that will be to your right. Thank you.
All right, so it's the opening video. We're gonna head on in, and then they're gonna make shut off the camera before the actual video starts, and that'll be our last time in here.
Come on in and find a seat. Any seat is a good seat to view our show from. Welcome once again to the Tomorrowland Theater and our special Captain EO tribute. How are you guys doing tonight? All right. Are you guys ready for our show? And you're all aware that this is the last day, right? Okay. A last day for Captain EO as of right now. You guys are lucky you get to come see it today on its last day. The exit? Are you guys at? Who asked for the exit?
Nobody.
I thought someone yelled for the exit. If you guys need to exit, you can go to the right through the doors at any time throughout the show. We are going to ask for you to please remain fully seated in the seats throughout the show. The floor is going to move for those of you who have maybe never seen Captain EO. There's going to be no eating or drinking allowed in the theater. Also, typically no photography or video recording. However, since it is the last day, you didn't hear it from me, but I don't care. Well, welcome to Captain EO, guys. Go ahead and put on your 3D glasses as we time travel back to 1986 with the return of Captain EO starring Michael Jackson. Enjoy, guys.
That was an awesome turn of events.
Of good and evil, where a small group struggles to bring freedom to the countless worlds of despair. A ragtag band led by the infamous Captain EO.
This planet doesn't look so dangerous, ID.
Is this it, Odie?
We'll see. Ah! We better find that landing beacon.
Hey, Hooter, we're almost there!
Oh, boy!
Don't get too close or you'll trip their intrusion alarm.
Yeah, don't blow it, you guys.
Relax, there's no problem.
No problem. Intrusion alarm!
Battle alert!
Battle alert!
Don't panic, that's what got us into trouble the last time.
What? It wasn't our fault last time.
It was Hooter's fault.
Right, it was Hooter's fault. Oh, Hooter!
Straighten up, man. It's the captain. It looks like we tripped their intrusion alarm, sir.
Addy and Odie blew it. They got too close.
We're going in.
Sir, the ship is in absolutely no condition to go into battle. And I thought we'd begin by cleaning up Hooter's bunk.
Russ, buddy.
Hooter!
Listen, the command considers us a bunch of losers. But we're gonna do it right this time because we're the best. If we don't, we'll be drummed out of the Corps.
We won't let you down this time,
sir. We're going to do it right.
That's right. We'll be perfect, sir.
By the book.
Okay.
Captain, there's something weird out there.
A patrol ship.
I thought so. Maybe we can outrun it.
It's going to ram us!
Congratulations!
And for him, 100 years.
blades of torture in my deepest dungeon.
Your Highness, my loyal companions and I accept these punishments.
We do?
Of course we do. He's our captain.
Speak for yourself.
We have come here uninvited and unannounced.
So, then we both admit to your stupidity. Why have you come?
To bring a gift, Your Highness. To someone as beautiful as you.
You think me beautiful?
Very beautiful within, Your Highness, but without a key to unlock it. And that is my gift to you.
So, let me see this gift.
Not only see, Your Highness, but hear.
back to 2014. Go ahead and remove those 3D glasses, collect all your personal belongings, and you'll be exiting to the doors that are on your right-hand side. Please do not forget to dispose of those 3D glasses in the bins that are right outside those doors, and have a magical rest of your night here at the Disneyland Resort.
All right, so that was a real shock that they allowed us to film it, which was really amazing. I haven't pulled my thoughts together yet of whether or not we'll be able to put this up on YouTube or not, because even though we were told it was okay, I don't know if Disney will agree, so we don't want them to take it down. But anyway, regardless, we were able to film it, and so we'll have that for prosperity, and that is awesome because it's a really cool part of just Disneyland history from the mid-80s to now. And so obviously Michael Jackson's quite a pop culture icon himself, and just that teaming with Disneyland and George Lucas and Francis Ford Coppola and the whole thing. It's a really cool part of Tomorrowland and Disney history, so that was awesome. Now, in leaving and talking to the cast member, what was really interesting, the feeling is that it's that's going to be it for Captain EO, and she said that the feeling is that it will probably not come back, although it's not been confirmed, because they only have the original, I believe she said 70mm, is that correct? I don't know. But anyway, the original print of this film, and that's the projectors that are in there. And they are replacing those projectors with digital projectors for Guardians of the Galaxy. So they think it's very unlikely that they would, replace those projectors again to put this old thing in that's just not even that popular. So that's really interesting. That's the first time I'd heard that. I don't know if that's more widely reported, but that they're actually making physical changes to the theater to accommodate what's going to happen with Guardians of the Galaxy, and that makes a lot of sense. So we'll see. It may open up in, September, and that'll continue going on, and maybe it'll be here another 20 years or something, and we'll be back in 20 years filming the closing at that time or whatever. But if not, it was really cool to be here at the end of this long run. It was a good run and a fun run. Obviously, Captain EO came back. This is the tribute version, so same everything, but just, coming back after Honey, I Shrunk the Audience. And so it was a good run, and glad to be here. Very cool little piece of slice of history. So until next time, we will see you in line somewhere.